job. I've got a job. I have. A proper job in an office with proper money and everything.
But what about your job at Mrs. A's? You can't let her down.
I can and I will. It's a dead end at Mrs. A's.
Where is this so-called job?
Birmingham.
Birmingham?
That's miles away.
What's wrong with a job round here?
You're all crap.
We've all got jobs round here.
Yeah, crap ones.
You're not moving to Birmingham. I forbid it.
Correct. I am not moving. I am commuting to Birmingham.
Commuting?
On a train. It's only 90 minutes each way. It'll be fantastic. I can read, write poems, stare out the window, nap. Probably meet attractive men.
But you have to get the tube to the station. What about your claustrophobia?
You've hardly been out of the cul-de-sac for years. What about your agoraphobia?
Oh, trying to hold me back as usual. The only phobia I've got is a dead-end life stuck in a rut phobia, unlike you lot. Ugh, it's Mum who's got agoraphobia and you who's got claustrophobia.
Don't speak to your mother like that.
I'm not. I'm talking to you.
I forbid you to go.
Oh, rubbish. And I'm a fully grown woman. Yes, all right. Very funny. Anyway, I'm going, so there's no point trying to project your fears and phobias onto me.
She's never been the same since she saw that therapist, you know.
Don't mention that, please.
Oh, but Dolly, you're doing so well here as a trainee manageress.
But there's nothing to manage. There's never any stock. I'm sorry, Mrs. A.
You're a fool, Dolly. One day this would have all been yours.
You must believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God and the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost, Jesus Christ.
Excuse me, miss, any small change?
Sorry, only got a tenner myself. Well, not only, but you know what I mean. Unemployed myself, you see.
All right, miss, don't go on.
I put the Queen's head round that way. Oh, for God's sake. What's the point of a machine if it doesn't work? Now what am I going to do? Oh, box matches, please.
You're wanting change for the machine, love?
Oh, yes, please.
Oh, sorry, love, don't give out change. You'll have to spend more than that.
But I need the cash.
Any small change?
No! Oh, sorry. Please, please, a one-day travel card!
Want to buy a travel card?
I've got one now, haven't I?
Want to sell it?
Let the passengers off first.
Bunch of animals.
Excuse me, excuse me. Move inside the train. Can't you hear the man? What's going on? I'm going to die. Why does everyone else look so calm? I can't stand it. I'm going to miss the train. What's the time? 7 more stops to go. That only lasts 2 minutes per station. Oh, God, come on, move. Oh, my God, it's my stop. Excuse me. Excuse me. Oh, so this is why no one moves into the middle.
All passengers for the Birmingham service should join the train on platform 9.
How undignified. Like heathens. What's the big hurry anyway? Well, I refuse to run. No. It's all right. Don't bother to help or anything. I'm fine.
Alan managed to salvage something for the conference.
Yeah, the firm needs people like him.
Bill, what are they shouting?
Bill's a good bloke.
They're sitting right next to each other. No, an annoyed look, not an admiring look.
Another beer, Ron?
Oh, God. Can't I have any privacy? I've got to eat it. I'm starving. I'll go to the loo. Oh, engaged. Hang on. There's someone in here. Use the other one.
Open up.
What's the matter with you, you idiot? There's someone in here. Oh, hello.
Ticket, please, love.
It's in my bag on my seat. Can you hang on a minute? I've just got to finish my, what I'm doing.
Sorry, love, it has to be now. Show me to your seat, please.
But I haven't finished my bag. Oh, never mind. Excuse me, that's unbelievably irritating. Do you mind?
I'm terribly sorry. It is annoying, isn't it? I'll just finish this game.
Haven't you finished yet?
No, sorry, I've got rather good at it.
Can't you lose deliberately?
I couldn't. I went to public school.
Well, can't you just move away?
Turn the volume down.
What, eh? What?
So where
Where are you off to, dear?
Sorry, non parlez-y anglais-y, pour favor, sorry.
Never mind, love, you can just listen. I'm going to visit my niece in Oxford.
Non comprende. Non understandi inglese, also stony deafy, and non lip readie either, pardon.
OK, love, I understand.
Hello, Mummy? Hello, it's me again, Mummy. Just calling to say don't worry about pudding on Sunday. Giles and I'll bring it, okay? Okay. Bye, Mummy. Bye. Giles, it's me again. Just phoned Mummy and told her we'll bring the pudding on Sunday. Yes, well, we've got a few days to think about it. I'll see you in a bit. Bye. Mummy? Sorry, Mummy. I know you're having a nap. I just want to tell you that I've told Giles about pudding. He wants to know what vegetables you're serving with the roast. He's been growing herbs.
Look. Why? Pourquoi? Un momento. Look, why can't Giles just phone Mummy and ask her himself? Sunday is days away. You'll be at home soon. Why can't you just wait till then? Just because you've got a new mobile phone. Ridiculous things anyway. Why do you have to show off and ruin everyone else's journey?
No, Mummy, it's okay. I've got my alarm. Tarragon, then. Bye. Get away from me. You're mad.
No, you're mad.
I'm sorry, madam, but you'll have to move. Come along.
But non parle inglese, like a vatsy.
She was speaking perfectly good, if rude, English a minute ago.
Look, I'm Spanish or French or whatever I'm speaking. Non parle.